Welcome, you pack of nurgling worshippers. Today we are going to take a look at every neckbeard's disgusting fantasy army, the Dark Forces of Slaanesh. So, what we're going to have here is some Games Workshop sprues, some 3D printed models, and of course some second-hand models. And we're going to take a look at them and also get the prices right, because many of you always have this, some of you all Redditors have this hate against 3D printing. You're always up in my comments saying that the prices aren't right, that 3D printing is piracy, is whatever, and even if it's piracy, I don't care, because we are talking about goddamn plastic toys. And yeah, you really need to explain me why you're so far up a corporation's ass and simp for them and defend them on some, man, I'd only have like 150 subs, like I'm a nobody, like you come onto my channel and you talk shit about just me doing myself printing fucking plastic toys so I can have fun with my friends. Like, man, if you're a Redditor, this channel is not for you. So, leaving this out of the way, what we are having here is around 3,000 points worth of models, and the 3D printing part, if some can guess, it's going to be like the Fiends, the Seekers, the two Keepers of Secrets, this whole bunch of Demonettes, whereas obviously those are second hand. Those are original. I don't know what this is supposed to be. I just printed it and put some contrast on it, and I don't know, it kind of looks good, but whatever, I just had it there. And we're going to have some, yeah, just some Games Workshop Seekers. Those models, I bought them all secondhand because, god damn it, what's up with Games Workshop prices these days? Like, my god. Five Seekers of Slaanesh, like five of those with the stupid pose, like who the fuck sits like that? Like, even, and of course they're gorgeous, like I love the Seeker very much. I don't like that Demonette so much, but the Seekers are always very good, but there's no dynamic for an army that's supposed to be very dynamic in nature. If I take like the three printed ones, like this fella right here, like, come on, focus, yeah, like that. Yeah, of course the Seeker isn't that, it doesn't have so many details, but at least the rider has some sort of dynamic, or like this one, at least. She is doing something, like her leg is on the Seeker, one is dangling down there, but there's something going on. But with these, they are, of course the Seeker is very good, but just the pose, like, it's like a child on those kid safety seats in your car, like, there's nothing really going on. And even if, like, five of those, like, just five, like, if I take those fives, Games Workshop wants around, I think, $30 and 25 euros just for fives. So you can guess that I'm not up for buying like 10 or like 60 of them, because I play Apocalypse level. Like, I love Apocalypse, I love Escalation back in 7th edition. I still play 7th edition, and I plan on playing 30k. I don't know if it's feasible, like I think it is, but me and my pals, we want to try it out, and I'm not paying 25 just for fives. So you can guess, like, I have around 40 of them, like 3D printed, like right here. You can guess the price, and it's a price I'm not willing to pay just to have fun in my own room. Like, it's not like I'm taking these to a Games Workshop and just harass everyone, like, oh my god, look at them, they're 3D printed, my god, I don't do that. I don't give a fuck. I just don't give a fuck. I'm not the kind of person that Games Workshop wants to be like. I'm not going to buy 3 to 5 boxes just to have the guy at the counter say, oh my god, you're so good, you're gonna love that army because you paid so much. No, I don't play 40k for that feeling. I play it for the sake of the feeling, I for the sake of playing it, but not for the sake of paying so much for plastic toys. Like this, for example, normally a Keeper of Secret costs around 85 euros, so it's going to be around $100 or $90, I don't know. But still, this one was free and it's good enough. It really is good enough for all intents and purposes. It is what I wanted, it's what I wish, and this is what I need. And also, Herbert, this is a gift from my friend. He bought the design and he printed it out for me. Like, and even if everyone would play Slaanesh publicly, I don't think that's going. I don't think their education or their childhood was any normal. But that's a video for another time. But still, this model, gorgeous. He paid around, I think, $10 for the design, but I'm not sure. So don't take my word for it. But still, plus the resin, it's going to be around like $20 max for a miniature that's supposed to cost $100. And same with these guys. Well, to be honest, I kind of fucked them up back then because I was lazy back then. I didn't clean them up properly, so I had a whole bunch of issues, and I didn't want to throw them away. But still, I painted them up. I had to speed paint them. Now remember, because I had to speed paint this whole army in just one weekend because I work all day and I'm how do I say? I don't work where I live, so I always have to go away and then only come from the weekend back here. So I had just one weekend to speed paint this fucking bunch, and I just woke up, I painted all day long. And I'm sorry if many of you don't like my paid jobs. I know it's not the best, but for all intents and purposes of having fun with my friends, it's okay, it's all right. I'm okay with it, they're okay with it. At least it's painted, because many of you people out there, you play Primaris Space Marines Imperial Fist chapter and you just have one layer of contrast on your figurines. Like, the ones who talk shit in the comment sections, you have no argument, because I know the type of people you are. Like, you don't paint shit. So anyway, what we got here is the phones. I always forget their name because their name is always so complicated. But 24 pack, 30 euros. I don't remember why I bought them. I think I wanted to use them for more time or for classic fantasy, but then I was like, fuck it, I printed a whole bunch of arms for them and then use them as demonettes, and maybe for 40k I'm going to use them as Slaangors. But yeah, also I had to speed paint them, so they aren't looking so fresh, but for all intents and purposes, it's alright. These I bought just like that from a friend of mine, same as the Seeker, same as the Mask, and same as the Old Keeper of Secret, who broke in 5 pieces because he didn't tell me in time that the base is magnetized. So I was like, oh cool, a Keeper, and then it just crashed on my table and broke apart. So I already told you it's about 3k points, but still money talking. If we talk in Games Workshop prices without counting the stuff I bought from my friend, we're looking at 600 euros, which would be like, I know, $700, maybe more, maybe a bit less, I wouldn't know. But still, we're talking about 9 fiends, 3 of them cost €40, and I'm like, 3 of those motherfuckers, 3 of those cost 40, And 40 is like, those are, tandoor kebabs. Of course, are they? Like 4 euros, yeah. I think because because of inflation, even the goddamn kebabs are becoming more and more pricey. But still, would you rather have 3 of those or 10 kebabs? It's up to you. Same as those. I have this horde of seekers, and of course, like they were monopoles, so I had to improvise a bit, like head swap and like arm swap, and make them a bit more different, like mirroring them. But still, it's an army I always wish to have, but I'm not willing to pay so much for models that haven't aged well. Like honestly, I love the horse. I love this demon horse. Really cool model. But like the slanesh butt with 3 butts and 1 butt, the rider is not, come on, focus. The rider is just not dynamic enough. Like if I get a shot here, ah yes, yeah, no, yes, this one. Like look at this. There is no dynamic. There is just like no dynamic going on, and those models are really old for what they are. 28, 25 euros for like undynamic models, it's not for me. Like you can see these were made for the fantasy era, but we're not in the fantasy era anymore. So otherwise what you're looking at is still an argument for 3D printing. Come on, focus. Yes. Because we are talking here like 600 bucks. 600 bucks, like 700 bucks if we are talking about, I don't know, extra stuff. So why would anyone pay so much, like willingly pay so much to have an army? Like of course you can pay Games Workshop for it, but still you have to look at the alternatives, and the alternative is having an actual army without selling your kidneys. Like you can print an army, play with it, and still throw them in the trash, but you wouldn't lose so much money still. Like this in resin, I remember I took like two bottles, two and a half, so it's around 100 euros, like 120. If I take 3 kilograms, I don't think it's 3 kilograms, but if 1 kilogram back then cost me 40 euros, so yeah, 120 versus 600 to 700. One number is smaller than the other. So yeah, still, I'm very proud of them, even though they have been speed painted in just 1 weekend. But still, I just hope that Games Workshop will get a kick in the ball and just realize that their market strategy is not viable in the long run. Because if I can have this in a week without selling my arm and leg, then other people can too. And for all intents and purposes, if you want to find those gals, if I can focus, just go on cults or thingy and just type demon builder or demonette builder or just builder, and just scroll and scroll until you find them. Because this is a free kit. It really is a free kit. There are not monopoles because, well, some of them are monopoles because I'm a lazy piece of shit, but the head, the torso, and the arms are all separate, so you really have a real builder which is free. But not so much for them. Like this one, it's one model, one STL file. I didn't bother to mirror it, so I printed like 9 of these and I just went with it. He cost me around $8 to $5, so still I'm not paying 3 models for 40 euros, so not going to do that. And these were a bit more complicated because It's not much of a builder. Like, you get five models and you just print them like they are. Like, these are really monopose models. So you have to do a bit of tweaking and twitching if you want to have some variety. But still, I saved so much money just printing the stuff I want to play with friends who are supportive of the thing we make, because we are still like, most of my audience going to be men around their 20s, 30s, even 40s, and we all spent way too much on plastic toys. And why not try saving some money for once? Because if Games Workshop is going to have this monopoly of the market, then of course we are fucked. Because the prices are going to go higher and higher, and it's not going to take an end, because all we want to do is have fun. We want to meet our friends and do all those crazy campaigns and like crazy battles, but it's not feasible. It's just not feasible because the entry price and the individual price of models is just way too high. So yeah, that's about it. Those are my 3D printed Demonet of Slaanesh, and I see you in the next one.